In this video, I'm going to be reviewing three new brushes for the tires and wheels by Max Shine. What's going on? So glad you're here and welcome back to the Wilson Auto Detailing community. If you're a pro detailer or a car enthusiast who loves everything auto detailing, then definitely consider subscribing. This is going to be a fairly quick and simple video. I just want to kind of get this to you guys. I always like updating you on different tools, products, and companies that I'm using, buying from, working with, all that sort of stuff. So many of you guys know I love a company called Max Shine. They have a particular long throw polisher that I did a video about that was fantastic. In fact, many of you guys in your detailing worlds have that polisher and have actually been using Max Shine's polisher for years, and you guys love it as well. Got some awesome feedback from this video, so I wanted to show you guys some more. And so in the nature of full disclosure, I do partner with Max Shine in certain videos with certain products and tools that they have that I specifically believe in. So in the last 2 years of being on YouTube and putting out videos after videos and having dozens and dozens and dozens of companies ask me to partner with them. In 2 years, Max Shine is actually the first and only company I've ever done a partnership with, because they're actually the only company out of dozens of other detailing companies that I actually believe in their products, and their products and tools I believe speak for themselves, and they were the only ones that kind of met what I would consider my qualifications to be able to be on the channel because their products are such high quality. So I want to show you guys a couple of their brushes right now, so let's get into it.
Now, this is a super dirty tire and wheel as well. This is not one that's been maintained or cleaned at any capacity, so just check that out on the interior. You guys can see the dirt as well as the brake dust. Sidewall of the tire is disgusting, and face of the wheel is bad as well. So there's just a quick before, so that when we look at the after, you guys can see what the difference is.
Now, many of you guys know I actually prefer using drill brushes on tires because it saves me so much time. So cleaning a tire, a sidewall of a tire with a brush manually is actually not something I really implement in my world in a lot of ways. However, many of you guys who follow the channel do not use drill brushes on tires because you think it's dangerous or whatever. I'm not here to argue about that. So I wanted to show you guys a brush that you can actually use in a manual way, even though this is not something I do a bunch in my world. This may be helpful for you. Now, before I start cleaning the tire, I am just gonna wet the sidewall a little bit, but I wanna kinda give you guys a couple notes of why I particularly prefer a tire brush like this over a tire brush that looks more like this. Now, this is also a product by Max Shine, and actually a lot of detailing companies have tire brushes that look like this, right? They have big handles, they're really a lot of surface area, right? Really, really firm bristles. Problem is, this kind of brush can be fantastic when you're dealing with like really, really big tires, but a lot of times people are not dealing with big trucks and big SUVs on an everyday basis. They're more dealing with kind of sedan-sized cars, mid-sized cars, and so naturally the tires follow suit. They're not all that big, particularly the sidewall of the tire. Now, I don't know about you guys, but I do have a little bit of trouble when it comes to, again, if I wasn't using a drill brush and I was doing it manually. When it comes to using a brush like this, it's kind of hard, and what I mean hard, I mean just like ergonomically. It's hard to hold this brush and put in the force that you want to put into it, as well as the detail you want to put into it, meaning getting in these tiny little grooves and cracks and crevices, getting in this tiny little area right where the crease of the tire meeting the wheel is. This is difficult to use for me. It might not be for you, but it's difficult for me to get as detailed as I want. What I love about a brush like this is, again, ergonomically, just like practically, it's easier for me to use, because rather than me having to put my pressure in almost right over the brush, what I mean is when I'm holding this handle, all my pressure is on top of the brush. Right here, I can angle the pressure, right? I can angle the part of the brush I'm using. I can get detailed with it because it's a long handle, so it's easy to grab, it's easy to maneuver, but it's a smaller surface area of brush, you know, it's smaller surface area of bristles. So I'm gonna go ahead and spray my Super Clean. Again, this is not diluted. Super Clean is an amazing degreaser. I use it for so many different things, and particularly on tires full strength. It works very, very well. Now, I'm not gonna be conservative with it whatsoever, but basically what I can do with this tire is, number one, I can go up and down just like I'm doing right here, so I can get into all of these grooves right here. It's much more difficult in my experience to do that with this. Number one, you're gonna hit the paint, right? You're gonna scratch up the paint if you're not careful. Number two, you're gonna scratch up the wheel if you're not careful. And number three, it's just difficult, again, because of the way this is shaped ergonomically, to get into like a detailed kind of motion with it when you have smaller surface area of bristles like this, it's much, much easier. I'm gonna spray a little bit of solution on the brush itself. And again, I can go up and down just like this. Apart from that, I can get in this tiny little creased area right where the wheel meets the tire without scratching the wheel. Again, that's a very important kind of concept right there. So I can come on the side, let the side of the bristles just barely touch the wheel, but again, clean this crease, this tiny little crease in the tire just like that, as you can see. And of course, this wheel has a pretty good amount of curb rash. And then on top of that, I can actually get into these grooves where the top of the sidewall of the tire is, right? Almost every single tire has these kind of treaded pieces. When you're cleaning truck tires, they're gonna be really, really heavily treaded. But up here, every, basically even sedan size has just these tiny little treaded pieces. And again, I can't take this kind of brush in between, kind of in this wheeled well area, right? Because I'm gonna be scratching up the lip of the wheel well. See that? I mean, it's just, there's no way I'm gonna be able to do that. Whereas again, with a smaller brush, smaller surface area, but a long handle that lets me kind of spread out the way I wanna put pressure, I can get in the wheel well and get in all of these cracks and crevices of the treaded part of the sidewall, just like this. And again, I'm going in the motion and in the direction of the tread. So again, with a brush like this, I'm forced to go sideways. With a brush like this, I can get into these cracks and crevices because I'm not going against the grain. I'm going towards the direction that these little tiny grooves are designed, and hence cleaning this area. So again, it lets me be very, very detailed, and it's just much easier. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish cleaning the sidewall with this tire. Spray a little bit more degreaser here just in case it dried up a little bit, and then just hose it off. And I'm actually only going to do this one pass because I just wanna see how well the degreaser and the brush clean together in just one single pass. Now you may recognize this brush, right? We call it the Speedmaster, we call it the Easy Detail Brush. Those are kind of the two bigger brands as far as this kind of design brush is concerned. So just for your reference, here's my Speedmaster brush, and then here's my Max Shine brush. That's really the same exact design, not really anything different other than the size, right? I actually believe Speedmaster has a brush this size as well that basically does the same thing, but again, I don't think I've ever actually shot a video about a brush like this. However, I suggest that many of you guys have this size of brush because it comes in handy for way more things than just wheels. But again, this is a wheel brush, has a little rubber tip right here, and then these bristles are very stiff, but they're very soft. So basically the idea for this brush is just getting on the interior barrel of the wheels, rather than just cleaning the face. Now, while I love my Speedmaster brush that is this size, when you're dealing with a car like this, it can get in these spaces, but it can't get in some of these spaces, because again, every wheel is different, every tire is different, and there are times when you're dealing with a smaller size car like a Prius where it would be much nicer to have a smaller version of that brush. Well, that's exactly what this is. Again, not much difference between this and the ones that Speedmaster put out, but again, this is branded Max Shine, but again, this is just put out by Max Shine, and this is a very, very, very good size brush to have. So I'm just gonna spray some Meguiar's Wheel Brightener on the interior here of the barrel of the wheel, and then I'm gonna clean it with this tiny little brush. Now, again, not only, here's just a couple notes as I'm cleaning, not only is it easier to physically just fit this brush in certain areas, but it's also easier to control, right? Because I don't have such a long handle, I don't have such a long brush, I can control where it is, I can control the amount of pressure being put down a little bit easier than a bigger brush. Now, while I definitely suggest getting both this size and a larger size just like I have, it is very, very nice to be able to work with a brush this size when I'm dealing with smaller wheels. It just makes my life easier, and I like to say, as I say on my website a lot, the right brush has the power to literally completely change your detailing world. So even if it's just a size difference, not necessarily a design difference, it really does have the power to change things in a very, very big way. Now the last brush I got here is again put out by Max Shine, but you might have recognized it, right? There's several different companies that have brushes very similar to this. And this is what I would just call a detailing brush. Of course, this can be used on the engine, it can be used on air vents, it can be used on wheels, right? And again, this is just a very, very good brush to have. It actually comes in a kit of three. The other two are just a little bit smaller, and then again, a little bit smaller than this one. But basically, the way I'm gonna use it in this application is, again, it could have a ton of different applications, but here, the reason I like to use it on the face of a wheel like this is because number one, it's extremely soft, it's not gonna scratch anything. Number two, it's extremely stiff, so it's gonna agitate the cleaner very well. And number three, it's gonna let me get into all these little nuts and bolts, these areas that I wouldn't otherwise be able to get into and clean the brake dust or the dirt out of, right? And again, I'm not scratching anything. But one particular note with the face of a wheel is very simply the brake dust that builds up on the face of a wheel is not gonna be even close to as difficult to clean as the brake dust that builds up on the interior of a wheel. So what I just cleaned with the other brush, the interior kind of wheel barrel cleaning brush, is much more difficult relative to this. All this is gonna require is just a little bit of agitation with this brush and with the Meguiar's wheel brightener, and I'm gonna be done. I'm not gonna have to spend a bunch of time. So I'm not speeding this up just because I want you guys to see how quickly it happens. And that's it. I'm just gonna spray. Now I'm gonna let that dry for just a little bit, and then we'll come in and check out just the finished dry results. So here is the dry after result of, well, the Super Clean, the Meguiar's Wheel Brightener, and then particularly what I'm reviewing in this video, the three Max Shine brushes. So check out the tire sidewall first. See how there's just no grease or grime or grunge left whatsoever. You might see a tiny bit, if I stand back a little bit, you might see a tiny bit of like what I would say like is a hue or a tint of browning, maybe a little bit up in here. That's not actually dirt, what we call anti-ozonate. It's called a blooming effect in a tire. I don't really want to explain what that is in this video. Basically, that's supposed to be here, there. It's manufactured into the tire, into the rubber, and that comes out when you use a degreaser on it, and you don't actually want that to be cleaned off. So this color you see right here of the tire sidewall, that's actually exactly what you want. This sidewall, this rubber tire color right here, it's black. It's just totally kind of stripped, right? There's nothing on it. That's what I want. In these grooves of the tire up here in this treaded piece, you see there's no dirt in there, right? That's all cleaned out. That has been taken care of. So it looks fantastic. Now let's look at the wheel, the face of the wheel and the inner barrel of the wheel. You guys can see there's no longer any brake dust back in there. Hopefully you guys can see that. See if I can focus in there. Let's see. No dirt, no grease, no grime. And then of course, on the face of the wheel looks fantastic. There's no scratching. You guys can see the brushes didn't scratch. They just cleaned very well. So there it is. All three of these brushes did a fantastic job. Now again, many detailing companies have brushes that are, you know, basically the same or similar to these. One of the reasons I love Max Shine is because of the quality that I know they produce. And for those of you who have used any of the Max Shine products and or the Max Shine polisher that I did a video about, you guys know what I'm talking about when I say affordable prices, but really, really quality work that they put into all their tools. So again, if you guys want to check out any of these, definitely use the links in the description box below. I'll hook up links that take you to all of this, as well as a link to my website, detailingjunk.com, where I have information about everything auto detailing that you could possibly need, and I try to cut through all the hype and all the BS in the industry so that you can just get to the products and know how they work, get good, reliable reviews, instead of having to search the forums and get more confused. And again, if you're a pro detail or a car enthusiast who loves everything auto detailing, then definitely consider subscribing to the channel. Once again, thank you guys so much for being involved in the Wilson auto detailing community. And as always, from Luke, keep working hard, and I'll see you guys in the next video.